Hey, this is Mary the Medicine Woman, and this video goes along with my blog post called Today is a Great Day to Reconnect. I have my daughter Ariel McCleary with me again, and today we thought we'd talk about, what are we going to talk about today? How to
stir up good memories.
And why would you want to stir up good memories?
When you are preparing to reconnect with somebody, you want to have some memories in mind of good times that you've had that you both have shared.
Yes, for two reasons. Mm-hmm. One, it'll get you into like a warm, fuzzy feeling, a happy place. And number two, you might want to pull one of those out, one of those memories out, if you feel like there's still like a little bit of tension.
Yeah.
So that's two really good reasons to have some good memories in the back of your mind.
Yes.
So how does one get those memories? How do you remember?
Some ideas that I thought of are going through old photo albums, or whether it's on your phone,
yes,
or like actual physical photo albums.
Actual physical albums. You guys have. Well, yeah.
But depending on who you're reconnecting with, maybe it's been a long time and you want to look up something that you went through together in your childhood that's a fun memory. Mm-hmm. You can just go through a scrapbook and it'll kind of help you get back in that mindset of like, oh yeah, remember this, remember that, remember we were living here in that house, whatever.
Yeah, it could be location specific.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Just something that you shared that was happy. And then you had another idea about getting another person involved that you can call and say, hey, help me remember some good times.
Yeah. Maybe if you're trying to reconnect with a sibling, for example, but you're not that close with them, you could call your parents or your other sibling that maybe you're closer with and say, hey, do you remember when all three of us, like, we went to high school? Did something fun happen that you remembered from high school? And then they can help jog your memory also. And then you can bring that memory to the person you're trying to reconnect with.
Such good ideas.
Yeah.
And so you should choose yourself to be the one to reconnect. You don't have to be the oldest in the family. You don't have to be the one with the most memories. You don't have to be the one that lives closest to mom and dad. You can just choose yourself to reconnect. Even reconnecting like one or two members of a family brings the whole family closer. Mm-hmm. Yes?
Yeah, it's so true.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So thanks for watching and try that. Peace.